Welcome back to another video from Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. In this video, I am going to tell you a very simple, or we can say the classical definition of hormones. What is the basic definition of hormone and what are the different features of hormones? Or hum baat karenge about the endocrine glands as well. In the next video, we will be talking about all the important endocrine glands and all the important secreted by those endocrine glands in the human's body, or we can call it human endocrine system. आज बात करेंगे सिर्फ और सिर्फ डेफिनेशन की. ओके, सो बेसिकली द एंडोक्राइन ग्लैंड्स आर डक्टलेस इन नेचर. नाउ व्हाट डज दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग मीन? अगर हम बात करें डक्ट्स की, देन डक्ट्स आर ट्यूब लाइक स्ट्रक्चर व्हिच हेल्प्स इन द ट्रांसफर ऑफ मटेरियल फ्रॉम वन पर्टिकुलर ऑर्गन और लेट्स से टिश्यूज टू द अदर प्लेस. सो दीज आर बेसिकली डक्ट्स, राइट? But in case of endocrine system, or we can say in case of hormonal system, it does not require ducts at all. Why? Because we have already talked about the endocrine system. If this is a cell and this cell is synthesizing some sort of chemical messengers, they will enter the bloodstream. Okay? And after, getting attached to a receptor which is present on some distant organ, it will be taken by this cell. और उसके बाद एक्सप्रेशन जो है वो हमारे पास आ जाएगा. सो बेसिकली फ्रॉम अ सिंगल सेल, और वी कैन से द सेल्स ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर ग्लैंड व्हिच विल सिक्रीट सम केमिकल मैसेंजर्स, दे विल डायरेक्टली रीच द ब्लड फ्लो. सो दे डू नॉट रिक्वायर डायरेक्ट डक्ट्स फ्रॉम वन पर्टिकुलर ऑर्गन टू द नेक्स्ट वन. अगर ये सारी चीजें अगर डक्ट के थ्रू होती, देन आवर बॉडी विल बिकम इवन मोर कॉम्प्लेक्स, बिकॉज अ सिंगल हॉर्मोन will affect a lot of organs. So just imagine our body structure. For example, this is the hypothalamus, let's say. This hypothalamus is also getting connected to the kidney, to the liver, to the pancreas, and to the all other organs such as lungs and all those stuff. Alag-alag tissues mein. We are just talking about single gland which is just sending its duct to different organs. Aise aur bhi gland hai. Right? वो अगर इतने सारे डक्ट्स बना ले तो हमारी बॉडी विल बिकम वेरी वेरी कॉम्प्लेक्स एंड इट विल बी लाइक वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड आवर ओन फिजियोलॉजी. दैट्स व्हाई दीज आर बेसिकली डक्टलेस. व्हाट दे यूज्ड टू डू, दे हैव डिफाइंड अ मैकेनिज्म फॉर दैट कि हाँ भाई, हम यहां पर केमिकल्स छोड़ देंगे और ये ब्लड के थ्रू वहां पहुंच जाएंगे जहां इन्हें जाना है. और वो हमें कैसे पता लगेगा? आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू द मैकेनिज्म दैट देयर आर स्पेसिफिक रिसेप्टर्स प्रेजेंट ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ अ सेल. Okay, for example, there are five cells, let's say four. Okay, this is the receptor, this is the receptor, this is also, and this is also the receptor. But this cell has the specific receptor for this chemical messenger. So this chemical messenger will flow through this line, okay, and it will be unaffected. It will not be absorbed by the cell, it will be not taken by the cell, because the receptor is not specific for the chemical messenger. रिसेप्टर सिर्फ उसी चीज को लेगा जहां पर उसकी कंपैटिबिलिटी होगी. यहां पर कंपैटिबिलिटी नहीं है, नहीं लेगा. यहां से इट विल आल्सो पास बिकॉज दिस इज नॉट कंपैटिबल आल्सो, सो यहां से भी पास हो जाएगा. आफ्टर दैट दिस इज आल्सो नॉट कंपैटिबल. नाउ दिस सेल इज कंपैटिबल एंड इट इज हैविंग अ स्पेसिफिक रिसेप्टर आल्सो, सो द केमिकल मैसेंजर्स वुड बी टेकन बाय द सेल एंड आफ्टर दैट डिफरेंट एक्सप्रेशन वुड बी डन. नाउ आई एम यूजिंग अ वर्ड डिफरेंट एक्सप्रेशन. Are you getting this thing or not? Let me explain this thing to you. कि अगर कुछ लोगों को ना समझ में आ रहा हो तो उन्हें पता लगे that what is expression actually. Each and every signal used to give you some sort of stimulus. Okay? For example, मेरे पास एक signal आया that I have to synthesize a gene. Okay? Not gene, let's say protein from a gene. क्योंकि genes are already present in the DNA, but I have to synthesize the protein from a gene. So for that I do have a signal. So what will the signal do? The signal will be synthesized from the endocrine gland. Okay, and this is one cell of endocrine gland. So it is synthesizing the signal. The signal will come in the blood flow. After coming in the blood flow, that signal will be received by the specific organ. Okay, for example, my kidney cells. Okay, so the kidney cells will receive that signal. Okay, after receiving that signal will be amplified. there are some signals which cannot cross the plasma membrane. So उनके जो receptors होते हैं वो cell surface पे present रहते हैं. For example, if this is a cell and this is a signal which cannot cross the plasma membrane. Okay, there are different signals which can cross the plasma membrane also. For that, the signals will be or the receptors will be present on the inner surface, or you can call it in the cytoplasm. Okay. For example, there is steroid. अब यहाँ पे मैं steroid अगर बना देता हूँ, so that can cross the plasma membrane. So it will be having receptor either in the cytosol or at the nuclear membrane. But if this is a signal which cannot cross the plasma membrane, then the receptor will be present on the cell surface. It will take it and it will activate other proteins present on the plasma membrane. Okay? यहाँ पे भी कुछ proteins present होंगे. यहाँ पर सिग्नल चला जाएगा. After that, they will amplify them or they will secrete or synthesize some secondary messengers. Now the hormones are working as primary messengers. They are the primary signals जो कि आगे चल के activate करेंगे कुछ इनर प्रोटीन्स को जो कि सेकेंडरी मैसेंजर्स बनाएंगे. फॉर एग्जांपल साइक्लिक एएमपी, साइक्लिक जीएमपी, उस तरीके के हमारे सेकेंडरी मैसेंजर्स बन जाएंगे. वो सेकेंडरी मैसेंजर्स जो होते हैं बाकी सारी चीजें करने के लिए हमारे न्यूक्लियस के अंदर चले जाते हैं. ओके, नाउ इफ दिस इज द न्यूक्लियस, ओके, इट विल बी हैविंग द क्रोमोसोम एंड द डीएनए. नाउ इन दैट डीएनए देयर आर सम ट्रांसक्रिप्शन फैक्टर्स, ओके, दैट विल लीड टू द ट्रांसक्रिप्शन, यानी कि the formation of RNA from DNA. So the transcription will be done and after that the activated gene will be forming protein. So there is a sequential manner in which the gene is encoded. Basically the gene will be firstly transcribed into mRNA with the help of transcription process. After mRNA it will be translated into protein, and that protein is what? It is the expression. So if I am talking about that expression will be given, it means that each and every signal will, you know, go to the nucleus. It will tell the DNA to make some sort of proteins, to make some sort of enzymes or any kind of thing. So protein is the final expression. So what we have to do, हमें जीन को छेड़ना है जाके कि हाँ भाई अब mRNA बना, mRNA के बाद protein बना. That is the main work. Okay? So that is the expression what I am talking about. So basically क्या होता है, the signal is secreted, after that it will go into the blood flow में जाने के बाद it will be taken by the specific receptors only and the expression will be given, which is the desired expression. Okay, so this is how it actually takes place. So they are ductless. I hope that this thing is clear, because they are traveling via the blood flow, so they do not require any kind of tubes, any kind of connections or ducts. Now the endocrine glands used to secrete some chemical messengers which are called as hormones. So what are hormones basically? If we talk about the very simple definition, hormones are the chemical messengers which are secreted by the ductless endocrine glands. Okay? Or kahan pe? In blood. Because they are ductless, so they will be directly falling into the blood flow. If we talk about the classical definition, then it will take in, consideration all important chemicals. For example, they are the non-nutrient messengers. Okay, non-nutrient, it means that they are not providing nutrition, they are taking stimulus to a particular organ. Okay, so they are non-nutrient messengers, and this particular thing also include a variety of species, chemical species which are secreted by the endocrine glands. So this is a good definition. Okay, so non-nutrient word is very important. You have to mark it down. आप इस चीज को underline कर लीजिए please. Non-nutrient, it means that it is not nutritional. It is not giving any kind of food to you. It is not giving any kind of oxygen. But it is giving stimulus or it is giving signal. So they are basically the chemical messengers. Okay, so the next line is chemical messengers which are intercellular. Intercellular means in between two cells. For example, autocrine signaling को अभी थोड़ा सा side में रख दी दीजिए, क्योंकि मुझे पता है काफी लोगों के दिमाग में क्वेश्चन आएगा कि ऑटोक्राइन सिग्नलिंग में देयर विल बी सिग्नल इन द सेम सेल, बट दैट इज एन एक्सेप्शनल केसेस, दैट इज जस्ट फॉर ग्रोथ फैक्टर्स एंड सेवरल अदर सिग्नल्स. बट इन मोस्ट ऑफ द केसेस यू नीड टू सिक्रीट समथिंग एंड यू नीड टू सेंड इट टू अ वेरी लार्ज डिस्टेंस. ओके, सो इन बिटवीन द डिस्टेंट ग्लैंड्स, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. तभी हम इंटरसेलुलर की बात करें, बिकॉज वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द डिस्टेंट ग्लैंड्स और डिस्टेंट ऑर्गन्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, दिस इज द ग्लैंड, this is another organ, So it will be secreting something which is received by this organ. So it will be intercellular. Intracellular means in the same cell, which is a kind of autocrine signaling. But here we are talking about the distant organs. So हम यहाँ पे intercellular को consideration में लेंगे. Then they are secreted in the traced amount. Traced amount simply means that minute amount, बहुत ही कम quantity में. Why? Because these are very very specific. ऐसा नहीं होगा कि they will be wasted. Not at all. Because since they are very specific, if I have four molecules of this hormone, the four molecules will not be absorbed by these cells because they do not have receptors for that. The four molecules will be secreted for this particular cell only because it has the receptor. So they are not wasted anyhow, and that's why they are produced in a very small quantity because they are very specific. Okay, more will be the specificity, less will be the quantity that is used. For example, enzymes. The enzymes used to increase the efficiency or the rate of a particular reaction up to million times. और इतने time जब बढ़ा देगा तो उसकी quantity बहुत कम होगी, obviously. क्योंकि उसका एक molecule million times बढ़ा देता है अगर rate को. So अगर हम 4-5 molecules भी synthesize कर देंगे for an enzyme, it will like shoot up the reaction to its highest extent. The same case is with hormones. Since it is also very specific, it has some properties like enzymes, but it is like quite different from enzymes as well. For example, enzymes jo hote hain, they are mostly proteins other than a few enzymes such as ribozyme, ribonuclease P. But hormones can be steroid, they can be amide, they can be protein. There are different variety of hormones. So basically they are very specific, so they are required in very minute content. That is what we have to understand. आगे पूरा डिटेल में आएगा, वी आर जस्ट टेकिंग एन ओवरव्यू. ओके, सो दीज आर द थ्री इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट. इंटरसेलुलर, ओके, दे आर नॉट इंट्रासेलुलर. इंट्रा मींस ऑटोक्राइन सिग्नलिंग. व्हेन यू टॉक अबाउट टू डिस्टेंट ऑर्गन्स, देन वी टॉक अबाउट इंटरसेलुलर सिग्नलिंग. दे आर प्रेजेंट इन वेरी ट्रेस्ड अमाउंट्स एंड दे आर नॉन न्यूट्रिएंट केमिकल मॉइटीज. आफ्टर दैट, इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द हार्मोनल सिस्टम ऑफ इनवर्टिब्रेट्स, दे आर वेरी वेरी small in nature because the number of hormones is very few. Invertebrates mein zyada complex kuch nahi hai, they are very simple in nature because they do not have that much amount of hormones in case of numbers or in case of physiology. Wo itne complex hain hi nahi, unme itni zyada chemical modifications kuch khas hoti nahi hai. But when we talk about the vertebrates do have a lot of endocrine glands. Those endocrine glands used to secrete a lot of hormones, and those hormones used to influence the physiology of a particular organism in variety of ways. So the number of hormones and the variety in which they affect our body is very vast in case of vertebrates. So if you have understood this chapter, if you understood the hormonal control and coordination done by the humans, you can understand any other control and coordination in any other organism because we are the most complex one. Okay, we are the most complex vertebrates. If you understood the physiology of human beings, you can understand the physiology of any other organism. क्योंकि अगर आपने यार सबसे ज़्यादा complex organism को समझ लिया, तो छोटे मोटे organisms उसी के अंदर आ जाएंगे थोड़ी बहुत variations के साथ. So that is going to be quite easy for you guys. Okay, so these are some important facts of glands and hormones. In the next lecture, I will give you an overview of the whole endocrine system, कि humans में कौन कौन से endocrine glands होते हैं and what are the different kind of hormones that they will secrete. So that is surely going to help you in your examinations very well. अगर आप लोगों को वीडियो पसंद आई, then do hit like button, share this video with your friends, subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for sure. Thank you so much guys.